Strange, enchanted ball. Thank you. Hi, my name is Steve Bishop. I'm here with the National Jazz Festival. I just got done adjudicating West Milford Highland Jazz Vocal Group. Thank you very much for submitting. I had a great time listening to your recordings. And I'm a little bit humbled trying to even make any suggestions to a man of Mr. Hayburn's stature. He's one of the great ones out there, and I hope everybody there appreciates the quality that he brings to everything he does. And this group is certainly no exception. So I'm just going to offer some thoughts, and they are what they are, and it's just my own, you know, shooting from the hip, and you can choose to do with what you want. First off, overall blend and balance, fantastic. Nice job. The groove, the feel, the style, all of that is, for the most part, really in top-notch shape. I'm going to go through each song and maybe offer a few specific ideas. Like anything else, as we certainly know in theater, we tend to give notes on thoughts we may want to fix and all that. I'm going to try to make sure you know when things went really, really well, because things really did go quite well with this performance. But I don't want you to take any of my critique as the simple fact that you didn't do well, because you certainly did. Anyway, maybe in the beginning, the very beginning of Nature Boy, consider more out of tempo movement, just to give a nice different style maybe to the overall performance. So something is out of tempo and really lyric and word choice driven. It was just a thought, you know, as I heard, but the balance, the chords, the harmonies, everything you're creating were fantastic. Really solid style. Be careful. There's a few times when you're longish notes, I'm not sure whether you're wanting to decrescendo, you're wanting to hold them out at the same level. I'm hearing a little bit of both, so I'm not quite certain what that is. So just be careful on those sorts of things. Certainly the style is good. Make sure the chords in the lower registers still pop. All right. Almost have to think backwards dynamics when you're coming up. The chords that sit in the lower parts of our voice, they still need to have resonance. And what ends up happening is, oftentimes the upper parts get lost in those harmonies, because you have to almost think crescendo going down, and the other parts, the lower parts, almost have to think decrescendo, so that the balance stays really, really clear as the parts go down. I might want to consider a little bit more aggressive D's on the dots, you know, before the scat section, and maybe a little bit more pronounced accents throughout all of that. Just a little bit more. But, oh my gosh, great balance and all of that. Soloists, nice job. The mic was a little bit late, but once it got up, you have a great tone, great style, very, very nice register. We got a little wonky on the ending, but things were pretty good. Again, at the end, we had to control some of those longer notes. I wasn't sure what you really meant by them. Are they supposed to be full out? Are they supposed to be decrescendoed? Either one can work. The choices are great. Either way, they just should probably be a unified choice. And make sure the top soprano, don't pull off the mic too much at the end. I know you're singing a high note, and I know you're trying to balance, but honestly, if the mic is anything more than, 8-10 inches away from your mouth, it's sort of not doing anything. So in a live room, we might be able to hear you, but in a recording, unfortunately, I kind of lost all the top energy. Neverland, great groove. The dotted quarter, the duplet stuff really came across. Man, the unisons and stuff are awesome. Just really be careful. The soprano part on this one, be careful in the tween notes. And by the tween notes, I mean sort of, I'm going to venture a guess in terms of the pitches, maybe between, say, C sharp to E-ish. those tweenish soprano notes sometimes get a little foggy, and we're losing some pitch clarity. And then you get higher, and it's just clean, clean, clean. So just be careful as we're working our placement in those registers. Scat, be sure you stay in time. Don't get ahead of the groove being set up by the group. But your choices, the scat choices, the notes, all of that sort of stuff was phenomenal. Very nicely done. Just be careful you sitting back in the groove. Primetime blues. Maybe in the beginning and the end, I have the same thing. Make sure the melody has a focus, right? Da-da-da is the melody. None of the held parts are actually melody. So we want to make sure that that is our focus. It's kind of like a spotlight in a musical or a play. You know, the spotlights or the lights should, if they're designed well, tell us exactly where to look at any given moment. You need to tell us exactly what we should be listening to by just the way you balance things, and make sure the movement is where the melody is in there. You go, bass. You know, I don't know any names here, but boy, you were popping the whole time. So fantastic. Maybe consider when you're getting into the repeats of the chorus, trying something a little bit different. Maybe it's a different overall dynamic for the entire group. Maybe it's a different style. Maybe it's shortening up the notes. Maybe there's some ways to change up the choruses. But again, it's nice to hear an a cappella feature within the group. So great program, really terrific choices, Mr. Hayburn. My hat's off to you as always. And gosh, like I said, I'm humbled to make any comments at all, because you guys are top notch. Thank you so much, and have a terrific rest of your school year.